Hi, welcome to my latest video. This is my little 16-seater minibus. As you can see, it's got a DVD player, which I should be using for my presentations. Using other people's work and also a bit of my own as soon as I get some results, some scientific results, which I can test and film. In the meantime, I'm going to use other creators' work. I'm sure they won't mind because it's going to be used as they want it to be used, to inform and instruct people and to maybe open their minds to the truth. Whether they absorb that or not, I don't know. But the idea is to get some people in here. I've got a cab heater, or a cabin heater, which is independent of the engine, which will keep it nice and warm. So I can park up somewhere, choose a nice spot, put a couple of signs out, which is the idea, and then start playing the DVD. Let me just play a bit of this DVD that I've got here. This guy is called D.Marble. Yes, M-A-R-B-L-E, that's his name. No pack drill, no BS, it's his name. Okay, Daryl, let's fire your video up, and if I can remember how to work this thing now. Oh, there we go. Okay, well, this is a DVD player, and this is the DVD I've got in here at the moment.
I'm getting sick of these trolls hopping on my posts, on my pages, on my videos with this ignorance. The fact of the matter is, water, bodies of water do not curve. That's it. That's the dead giveaway. You want to talk about the stars in the sky? You want to talk about the distance of the moon? You want to talk about why the rest of the planets off in space are circular or round, spherical? You want to talk about the space program? You want to talk about the seasons? You want to talk about why don't you have pictures of the edge? You want to say that there's actually pictures of Earth from space? But those are all CGI. The moon missions were fake. The moon landings, that was fake. NASA has lied about multiple things. You know this. But the dead giveaway of this whole flat Earth idea is that bodies of water do not curve. You know this. And what's happened is that you've been educated slash indoctrinated to a point to where you don't even trust your own five senses anymore. It just doesn't make any sense. If you've ever gone fishing, if you've ever been out to a lake or a river on a calm day, you know this. The water is laying flat. You see it here. So if it lays flat from this coast to that shore over there where we just zoomed in those houses, then it should lay flat everywhere. And I asked these trolls. I asked them. Heck, I sent a tweet to Neil deGrasse Tyson and Bill Nye. They're not going to respond, obviously. But the question is, how many miles out from the shore do oceans start to bend? When was that experiment conducted? Since everybody claims to be so into science and so focused on the scientific method, you are bound to the scientific method if you are part of the scientific community.
Okay, thanks for that, Daryl. That was a great bit of introduction to one of your videos on your channel. And anybody that wants to see more of this guy, he's straight up, he's 100% down the line, no messing, no BS. He comes up with fact. Comes up with his observations, which he's made and tried and tested, and they are beyond fault because he's telling the truth. The guy is D.Marble, D.Marble on YouTube.com. That's YouTube.com. Go and have a look at some of his videos. You'll be amazed at the effort and the time he's put into producing. And there's many, many more people like him. He's not alone by any means. There's some great content producers on YouTube on this very subject. Okay, well, getting back to this thing, as I say, this is, I'll just tuck this up a minute and turn it off because I've just done this to record for this video, this short video. As you can see, the wires are all over the place. I've got to get the thing hardwired in neatly so I haven't got these things hanging down. This is just a temporary measure at the moment. Also on board, I've got my primary proof of what he says and what the other content providers say is true. This is the primary. There you go. KJV version. Not particularly crazy about it, but nonetheless, it tells the truth. There is your primary reason for the subject and for belief. Because the Creator doesn't lie. He just does not lie. Let God be truthful and every man a liar. It's in the Bible, and that is so true. Everybody's lied at some point, if they aren't still doing so, including myself. Well, however small, however insignificant you might think those lies are, a lie is a lie. It's a non-truth to deceive. So that's what we're working on. Okay, so I've got this little, let's get back to this contraption here, which is not part of this bus, is actually just stood there. It's a little wooden construction I knocked together. I'm no woodworker, as you can see, but I knocked this thing together because the idea is when I get these little presentations going, I'm going to be parking up somewhere. I've got a cabin heater, which will keep this nice and warm and toasty for everybody if it happens to be cold weather. And also, after I run a video, and done a bit of a spiel, I'm going to be making hot drinks. They're going to be free. They're not going to know they're going to be free. I'm not going to advertise it because you know what will happen. People just want to come on board, grab a cup of something, and then clear off. Well, that's not going to happen. They are going to hear a bit of truth, whether they want to or not. If they don't want to, then, you know, fine, they can just get off. But the idea is to get them interested enough to sit, watch a video, do a bit of a talk, and then have a break, give them a hot drink, and then you could either stay and watch the next video and the next bit of presentation, or they can leave after. But they certainly will be watching at least one video and having a bit of a talk before the hot drink happens. Okay, well, let me just get round in. I've got a couple of posters made up, which are A4s. I need to stick one of these on the back door. I've already got one on the back door, which I'll show you in a moment when I get out. But there's your proof. There's your verses. Okay, that's that one. That's going on the back door. Here's another one. Sorry, the lighting's not very good in here. It's not a particularly brilliant day, and I've been inside. I think you get the gist of that. Right. So, let's make our way outside. Oh, I've got another little object of interest.